Some people are afraid of chemical structures, but we need to use symbols to denote the elements contained in chemicals. Our bodies are composed of chemicals. We should be able to describe our bodies or any biological events by chemical symbols. So today, I will discuss a professional way to use chemical symbols. With this approach, you'll be able to describe complex chemical structures. In chemistry, we identify elements with symbols that are organized in the periodic table, right here. So these symbols can be thought of as alphabet of a language. Elements can combine with each other to form a compound, which can be thought of as a word. Just as many words form a sentence, many compounds can form living organisms. Unfortunately, using element symbols is not very popular among the general public. After I returned to Japan from the United States, I went to a science museum in Osaka. At that time, science museum in Osaka was quite new. The exhibits in the museum were arranged helically from the top floor down to the lower floors in the order of physics, chemistry, and biology. So I was looking at a periodic table for chemical elements in the chemistry section. The one family came to the chemistry section. Then the mother said, "Oh no, this is the space for chemistry. Let's skip these exhibits." So chemistry is not really popular. When I was a high school student, I had difficulty with chemistry. I was expected to memorize many different things, including element symbols and formulas for chemical reactions. I thought it was really boring. However, I started appreciating the importance of chemistry to everyday life eventually. Evidence of chemistry is everywhere. Look at the refrigerators. They make ice. That's chemistry. Human diseases are treated with medicines or small molecules. Stockings protect our legs from the cold. Here, dye helps us look younger. Eventually, I realized that chemistry is richly flavored. All scientific disciplines have emerged because someone thought they are interesting and useful. So you need imagination. I did not become interested in chemistry until I began to use my imagination. I hope you're going to use your imagination.